pictures here than they have written.
Oh, well, that's a good idea with that.
I've looked high and low. I cannot find that New Year's Jet playbook.
If you didn't look in, underneath grass, kill it.
That's probably where it is. Yeah.
You know, that's probably where it is. But nobody knows anything. It's like Schultz on Hogan's Heroes.
Oh, really? We know nothing. Yeah, Belichick, if he had the book, he said, I don't know. What do you don't know? Give me a break. Gee, Aaron Hernandez went out to the hospital last year. Was he allowed to go in the hospital business now?
Yeah, now he was in the hospital. He's now back in the jail. They didn't say what was wrong with him. But they said it was not criminal related.
Good.
They're going to put something new. I know. This area here, immediate area, has changed a lot. And it's now evening on this 22nd of June of 14, excuse me. Oh, I hate to turn the clock back 5 years. Oh, stick with now. Now I'm on my way home from Ruby Tuesday in Taunton.
The fours or whatever it was next door. Into the garden where they had a restaurant in the garden. So we went from Red's office because there was some, once you won championships as we did in the 80s, they had a bigger crowd show up. It was 10 rounds in those days. It used to begin at noontime in the East.
Talk about the actual mechanics.
Well, basically, we would send two people down to the used to be Jeff Twist and somebody else was the lottery went down. But a lot of times in June, you get that fog in the morning, and the airplane's not moving. So finally when Fitz got there, he says, well, we gotta resend somebody down the day before. Because we could have got there, they could have fogged in, not having anybody actually there to give the call. I mean, it would have been done by phone, but it shows how the league now, they go down and have a big to-do the night before and so forth. But and what happened was when it became your turn, first round, you had 5 minutes to make a decision. And for the most part, the Celtics knew what they wanted. I remember the year that they really wanted to play kite. And nobody picked Blake to be a first round pick. Of course, we had the last pick because we had won the league, the championship the year before. So it came to our turn and we picked Blake Titan. So in those days, there wasn't a television or anything else. So I was the one that called everybody when they got drafted. And I remember calling because he went to the University of Jacksonville. And I called him, and his wife hung up the phone on me.
I went to BYU. Where from there?
Okay. But he was living in Jacksonville. That's where he was. Okay. I remember calling Jacksonville. But, so anyway, I finally made three attempts. And you got to realize, in those days, because there was not television or anything, all these guys' friends were calling and saying, I'm from the New York Knickerbockers, and probably they got fed up with it. Well, finally, I did get a hold of his coach. And he did call and say, yeah, you're getting a call from John Cleese. He's legit. And Greg was a terrific guy. And I went through that with Schweitz. Schweitz, remember him, John Schweitz? Because we had him in the sports exchange several times. And he was in Virginia, I think, one of the down there. And I remember the coach, because they had two or three youngsters on that particular team they thought would be drafted by somebody, again, 10 rounds and 20 teams. But it just so happened that John was the only one, and we picked him in the sixth round. And I got the coach, and he put it on a speakerphone in his house, so announced to their crowd there that John was the sixth round choice.